Get started this evening. I want to welcome you all. Thank you for coming to tonight's Spring Sports Awards night. I am honored to be able to begin this evening with recognizing our scholar athletes. As you all know here tonight, there are great demands placed on our student athletes, both during competition and during the school day. It is my pleasure to recognize this year's Spring Scholar athletes who have not only met the requirements set by their coaches, but also have excelled in the classroom. Athletes, please stand as we recognize this year's scholar athletes. Please hold applause until everyone is standing. We'll start off with baseball. Zach Shane, all A's. Carter Streetley, all A's. Aaron Stewart, all A's. Cyrus Holland, all A's. Justin Schroeder, all A's. Randall Mack, all A's. Jacob Houdeshell, all A's. Travis Watcher, Sheldon Albright, Peyton Shallow, John O'Dell, Brad Benouche, Wesley Vaughn, Andrew Feldman, Levi Brown, Dominic Thomas, and Brant Etchison. Jordan Mitchell, all A's. Ivy Brock, all A's. Shauna Ellinger, all A's. Hannah Meyer, all A's. Caitlin Sawyer, all A's. Emily Shepherd, all A's. Allison Webb, all A's. Sarah Birch, all A's. Katie Newton, all A's. Vonda Mullet, all A's. Kia Redinger, Caitlin Arthur, Quinn Bixler, Alyssa Cluninger, Michelle Henning, Callie Richard, Brittany Wright, Jordan Sheets, Kaylee Stump, Abby Barnes, Michaela Hall, Jessica Baldwin, Erica Inyard, Emily Rose, and Sammy Rupert. Brad Birch, all A's. Alex Gudeman, all A's. Adam Lunau, all A's. Jeremy Sheets, all A's. Dale Beck, all A's. Patrick Cades, all A's. Mason Yoakum, all A's. Tanner Hayden, all A's. Evan Downs, Ricardo Alos, Ramson Bednimrod, Willie Brown, Matt Hayes, Rhett Lee, Tyler Miller, Braxton Molden, Matt Basham, Garrett Bitterling, Austin Calvert, Tanner Campbell, Todd Pocock, Caleb Hunter, John Hunning, Jonathan Poon, Kian Powell. For girls tennis, Maddie Lewis, all A's. Caitlin Patterson, all A's. Adrian Pollock, all A's. Caitlin Bugno, all A's. Brooke Ewing, all A's. Aubrey Franklin, all A's. Miranda Glant, Karina Smith, Michaela Stockberger, Emily Johnson, Elena Franklin, Shelby Bankson, Shaylee Kelly, Cynthia Hernandez. Ball, Brady Bryant, all A's. Adam Basham, all A's. Noah Roberts, all A's. Chris Hoffman, Quentin Albert, Luke Kennedy, and Alex Denny. Softball, Laney Schroep, all A's. Abby Malco, all A's. Maggie Good, all A's. Riley Holland, all A's. Bailey Abbott, Alexis Hampton, McKenna Morgan, Carly Murphy, Kaylee Smith, Aaron Johnson, Sarah Amick, Laney Smith, and Taylor Pinstamaker. Next, we would like to recognize the Academic All-TRC Award winners. And this year's Academic All-Conference Honorable Mention winners, to reach that goal, if you have to have a 3.2 GPA and be in the top 30% of your class. This year's winners are for track, Ivy Brock. You guys can all come up. Alex Gudeman, Brett Lee, Braxton Holden, and Quinn Dixon. Baseball, honorable mention Academic All-TRC Aaron Stewart. All right, at this time I'd like to recognize the Academic All-TRC Conference honorees. This requirement would require a 3.6 GPA and being in the top 15% of the class. For track, Lauren Mitchell, Anna Meyer, Caitlin Sawyer, Shauna Ellinger, Jeremy Sheets, Brad Birch, and Evan Downs. For baseball, Academic All-TRC, Zach Shane. For softball, Academic All-TRC, Abby Malco, Randy Schroep, and Maggie Good. Thank you. Congratulations, athletes. You truly represent Rochester very well. I want to thank all the coaches and all the parents for supporting our athletes, for doing school work, and supporting your students. I would like to wish luck to all the athletes that are still competing. And I would like to just take a moment real quick and just recognize this being the last athletic awards for the year of our athletic department. Mr. Miller and Mrs. Cash, I believe Mrs. Cash is here as well. I'd like to give them a round of applause in just a second. They spend a lot of time, countless hours, working on scheduling, getting officials, making sure buses are on time, and communicating that out to the public, and they do a great job, and they really provide our athletes a lot of support. And so I want to thank them, and let's give them a round of applause.
Mr. Snyder, thank you very much. I appreciate that. I'll also echo those comments with regards to Mrs. Cash. Some of you know that I was on a four-week football sabbatical during the month of May this year, and although I was in contact with Mr. Snyder and Mrs. Cash on a daily basis and trying to keep things going as best I could, things could not have gone smoothly without Jason's help, and most especially without Mrs. Cash's help. So if you'd give those two a big round of applause. We do have a group of outstanding senior athletes that I want to recognize very quickly. Some of you may or may not be aware, but our athletic directors in the Three Rivers Conference this year decided to put together what we call a TRC Mental Attitude Award. A year ago, we started the Distinguished Academic Honor Award for senior athletes in the Three Rivers Conference. And Rochester High School this year was fortunate enough to have four people recognized, or actually three people recognized as a TRC Mental Attitude Award. They had a banquet at Eugenia's, and Mr. Snyder took those individuals over. In order to receive the Mental Attitude Award, the athlete had to be a senior who excels in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership. The athlete must be nominated by the coach and endorsed by the principal and athletic director in the TRC schools. And we had three seniors who were honored at that banquet. I would just like to have them stand and be recognized. First of all, a winner in football and also nominated in basketball and baseball, Zach Shane. Secondly, a winner in girls soccer, Kelsey Heller. And in basketball, a winner in girls basketball and also nominated in softball, Abby Melko. I also would like to have Zach stand one other time. He was also a member of the Distinguished Academic Honor Award. He was one of seven senior athletes in the Three Rivers Conference. This is for being in TRC Academic All-Conference Honor Roll for five of the six seasons during your junior and senior year. Obviously, you have to be a three-sport athlete, and in Zach's case, he was 6 for 6. So congratulations, Zach. As Mr. Snyder alluded to it, spring sports are a little bit different. Every year when we get up here on this Wednesday, we still have golfers that are going to compete virtually every year, either baseball, softball, or track athletes are continuing their competition. And this is no exception this year. First of all, our boys golf team will play in the sectional at Dykeman. I believe first tee time, you tell me, a little after 10 on Friday, on graduation day. And so I want to recognize and wish good luck to the members of the boys varsity golf team. Secondly, Miss Anna Meyer was crowned sectional champ in the 3,200 meter run. She broke a record. She turned around the next week at the regional and broke her own record one more time. And we're hoping that she's going to have one other opportunity to break that record again. She'll be participating in the state track meet at Bloomington this Friday. So congratulations. And last but not least, many of you were made the trip to Lake Station yesterday, and our girls softball team did something that no other girls softball team has done at Rochester High School, and that is win a regional championship. We were crowned sectional champions a week ago on Tuesday. We won the regional. We will continue to play this Saturday versus Adams Central at Eastern High School in Greentown at 1 o'clock, and plan on being there for the sectional or for the semi-state championship at 7 p.m. also. So, members of the girls softball team, if you'll please stand up and be recognized. Thank you very much. We do have special senior awards to give out tonight. Very quickly, before we move into our second areas of awards, the blanket award at Rochester High School is earned by accumulating 60 or more points during a high school athletic career. An athlete can earn 7 points for each varsity letter one, 5 points for seasons as a varsity manager, 3 points for freshman or JV participation, and 2 points for seasons as statisticians or other support groups. In almost every case, a young man or young lady must be involved year-round as an athlete, manager, or trainer to earn the blanket award. In addition to the 60 points, an athlete must exhibit good citizenship and behavior through graduation. Each blanket award winner must have defended all letters earned during his or her junior year in that same sports season. From the class of 2012, there were about 93 student athletes that competed over the past 4 years. 77 of them earned varsity awards at some point in time during their career. Only 5 of those athletes have earned enough points for the blanket award. And Mr. Snyder is going to help me and pass those out as we bring up our blanket award winners. We'll start out with our young ladies. First of all, Michaela Stockberger. Michaela participated in 12 seasons. She earned 63 points. She's 3-year varsity award winner in girls tennis, a 2-year varsity award winner as a manager in boys tennis, 3-year varsity award winner in cheerleading. As I said, she participated in 12 seasons and earned 63 points. Michaela. Our next young lady participated in 13 seasons of athletics at Rochester High School, Ms. Lauren Mitchell. She earned 87 points. She's 4-year varsity award winner in soccer. She's a 3-year varsity award winner in cheerleading. She's a 4-year varsity award winner in track and a 1-year varsity award winner in swimming for a total of, once as I said earlier, 87 points, Lauren Mitchell. We have 3 young men who qualified for the senior award blanket. First of all, starting out, Mr. Aaron Stewart. Aaron participated in 10 seasons of athletics at Rochester High School. He earned 62 points. He's a 4-year varsity award winner in tennis, a 3-year varsity award winner in baseball, and a 1-year varsity award winner in boys basketball. Mr. Aaron Stewart. Our next young man, Austin Sossaman. Austin participated in 10 seasons athletically at Rochester High School. He earned 60 points. He's a 2-year varsity award winner in football, a 3-year varsity award winner in wrestling, and a 3-year varsity award winner in track and field. Austin Sossaman. Our last blanket award winner from the class of 2012, Zach Shane. Zach participated in 12 seasons. He earned 72 points during that time. He's a 3-year varsity award winner in football, 3-year varsity award winner in basketball, and 3-year varsity award winner in baseball, Mr. Zach Shane. Please give all of these student athletes a big round of applause. Congratulations. Okay, at this time, we'll move into the section of awards where we give our team captain awards, our most promising, most improved, mental attitude award winners and MVPs. I'll read a brief description. We'll start out with girls tennis and Coach Hooker, followed by boys golf and either Coach Hoffman or Coach Lingenfelter, track and field, boys and girls, Coach Hell, and then baseball with the other Coach Hooker, and softball with Coach Holland. The first awards that we give are team captains. Leadership is often the intangible that is missing on those teams that never seem to fulfill their potential. At the same time, it's very evident on those teams that rise to championship levels. Team captains must serve as leaders, as recruiters, as assistant coaches with younger players, and as positive role models for all team members. Starting out with Coach Tammy Hooker.
All right, the goal for our captains, obviously, is to lead the team with positive role models both on and off the court. They are voted by their teammates to lead the team for this particular season. And this year, our senior captains were Michaela Stockberger and Miranda Glenn.
We don't choose captains prior to the beginning of the season and track because we like all our athletes to behave like captains at all times. But at the end of the season, we allow our students to decide those criteria best, and their selections on the girls' side were Caitlin Sawyer, Anna Meyer, and Lauren Mitchell.
Our next category awards are those of our most promising athletes. It's important that coaches continue to work hard.
Yes.
We've got three captains this year. These guys have led us tremendously, and some of them are pretty loud. Some of them not quite. You guys will know when they stand up here. the three senior captains, Aaron Stewart, Zach Shane, Travis Winter.
We'll try this again, the most promising athlete. It's important that coaches continue to work hard to recruit the best possible athletes for his or her sport. It's especially gratifying when a coach gets a young man or a young lady in their freshman or sophomore year that show the talent, the potential, the determination, the positive attitude to be a real champion in their high school career. Hopefully the awards earned here tonight as most promising will serve to encourage each of these athletes on the bigger and better seasons in their RHS athletic careers.
Starting to learn to play tennis on a competitive level in your high school freshman year can always be a challenge, and by the end of the season we always see a huge amount of growth. I had two great freshmen that have grown to become very competitive and confident on the court, and it is very exciting when someone takes off with loving a sport so much and playing nonstop with anyone and everyone that she can get a hold of. So our most promising has plans for summer camp and working on her game for years to come. That competitive drive that she has is exciting for me. Her first year season, she went 11-4 at singles and 1-0 at doubles. I hope that she continues to love this sport and reaches her goals as a tennis player here at RHS. Shelby Bankson.
Promising athlete is someone who probably has the most athletic, technically sound golf swing of the freshmen and sophomores. He oozes confidence. There's no shot that he thinks he can't hit, which at times can get us into trouble because he hits some shots that maybe he shouldn't, but in golf that's a very important thing. And so when I think of who our most promising player is, he wasn't the lowest scoring freshman or sophomore, but I'm greatly looking forward to the next few years. They're going to be exciting, fun, and very interesting having our most promising player, Marcus Smiley.
To reduce confusion, I'll read about both of our most promising athletes before I invite them onto the stage. Start with this young lady. She's a freshman, and in an average year, she would have been the best distance runner on the team, but we had Anna Meyer on the team, so that's a pretty stout competition. She's a very competitive runner, and if you look at her numbers from this year, she stacks up very well to what Anna did in her freshman year. She qualified for regionals in three events, which was tied for the most with Caitlin Sawyer and Anna Meyer. She placed second in conference in the 3200, and she helped break a school record in the 4x400 relay. Sandy Rupert is our most promising athlete. Our most promising male athlete is also a freshman. He started the season very quiet. Didn't look very comfortable on the team, but he was mentored by a very good athlete, Ramson Bednemirod, and the two together worked on his high jump along with Coach Reeves, and Caleb placed in every meet of the season. He ended up placing fourth in sectional and being the only regional qualifier in high jump in our entire regional that was a freshman, And I'm very proud of him, Caleb Hunter.
For baseball this year. This young man had to play a lot of varsity baseball for us, played some JV, and his potential is really off the charts, and that's because of his competitiveness. That's what I can say that stands out most about this young man. Most promising, Jacob Havishel.
Successes of our programs.
I can always tell when one of my players has spent some time on the court during the off season. And we've got the summer and the fall, and we've got lots of busy athletes who are involved in other sports. And so I have to allow a lot of other sports to take precedence sometimes. But our most improved lady is a very competitive young lady who was ready to play the moment that she stepped foot on the court in March. And wasn't that a wonderful March that we could be outside and playing on the courts? She always wanted ideas to improve her game and made her very successful on both singles as well as doubles teams. I think we can expect another great year next year out of Brooke Ewing.
This young lady had a tough start to her career because she picked an event that we were pretty loaded in. For the past 2 or 3 years, we had the sectional number 1 and 2 in pole vault in Ashley Minix and Hannah Ogrey. So Jordan Sheets had to be patient and wait her turn. And she got a chance this year when the two graduated. She had a setback in the middle of the season when she missed the mat and got a concussion during practice. She came back very strong. She was the conference champ in pole vault. and sectional runner-up and regional qualifier, Jordan Sheets. In the voting for awards amongst our team, this was the closest one, but when it was all said and done, we agreed as a staff that this was a good selection. This young man's a sophomore who over the summer worked very hard. He had a good cross-country season and worked hard again in the winter and in his off-season. He worked his way into an occasional member of the 1600 and 3200 meter relay teams. In the 800, he cut 14 seconds off of his time from last year, and in the mile, he cut 40 seconds off. Nick Scheidler is our most improved athlete.
Our most improved player this year, we'll go back to last year. I'm not going to lie, when he came up to play sometime, the confidence was not there for me. I don't know about him, but this year he put in a ton of work in the off season, and his jump from last year to this year was remarkable. Our most improved player, senior Travis Watson. Mental Attitude Award winner is our next category of awards. The coach's favorite person. It may be a unique way to describe this award, but in many ways it's true. The question you need to ask yourself is, why is that player the coach's favorite? The answer will be because he or she always listens and tries to do what is right, always hustles during all practices as well as in contests, always tries to provide leadership, be a positive example for the underclassmen in the program. Talent and potential are not qualities needed for the Mental Attitude Award winner. A never say die attitude coupled with a positive outlook on life are the qualities of all of these Mental Attitude Award winners.
Mental Attitude Award is for that person that has had a good competitive attitude, no matter if she was playing varsity or JV, singles or doubles. She always gave 100% and understood the ever-changing lineup. She always played through an entire match with energy and enthusiasm and was a great example for others. This year, our Mental Attitude is for Adrian Pollock.
Attitude is probably one of the most important characteristics you can have, because you hit most of your shots somewhere other than where you'd like. Most of your shots don't turn out like you want them to. It's hard to not be, if you have an attitude that's maybe a little too flippant, maybe you don't care enough, because in golf you really need to care, you need to be focused. And then at the same time, if you're too hard on yourself and you get down every time you hit a bad shot, you're probably not going to do real well. we have just a top-notch young man that played for the team this year. And again, on his ability level, I didn't really expect a whole lot this year. I didn't really know what to expect, but I didn't expect a ton. And he just had a tremendous attitude. He listens well. He's very teachable, coachable. And I like to think, as a golfer, he has one of the best attitudes because he just seemed very businesslike. He didn't seem like he got down on himself too much. And round after round, he didn't have the lowest score, but he always seemed to be there contributing and posting better scores than we thought he might. And so this year's Mental Attitude Award winner is Brady Bryant.
The young lady who was selected for Mental Attitude on the track team is a young lady who switched sports in her junior year. She had previously been a softball player. She came over to track, and it looks like things worked out for both teams. We got a really good girl who will do anything you ask, never complains, goes about her business, and I'm glad to see her teammates recognize it and voted for her. I'm really happy to give this award to Ivy Brock. On the guy's side, I really struggled with giving this award to this athlete, not because he didn't deserve it, but because he really, really deserved it. This guy's a junior, and last year at this time, he won the award as well. And I really hate to give the same award twice, but his teammates chose him by a 3-1 margin over everyone else. And when I sat down and tried to think of some reason not to give it to him, I couldn't come up with one. He's a terrific guy, he's our biggest fan, he works hard, and he cut 8 seconds off his 800 PR this year, 17 seconds off the 1600 PR. Brad Birch is our Mental Attitude Award.
This year's Mental Attitude Award goes to a young man who really it's a process throughout the whole year on how he brings about a solid work ethic day in, day out, and always talks maybe a little bit too much at times, but he's there every day, and has been a great baseball player for 4 years in regard to what his work ethic says every day, day in, day out. Senior Travis Watching.
Just a few comments that our teammates had to say about her. Never too high, never too low, always has a positive attitude, always hustles, and does her best, always performs in tight situations, always has confidence in her team. Riley Hoffman.
Our last awards are our MVPs. Most valuable athlete is the person who means the most to the team. Most valuable athlete is not necessarily the most talented, but it is a player that contributes the most to the program. Most valuable athlete must provide leadership and also exhibit outstanding skill in the sport. I believe one way to determine who the MVP is, simply ask yourself the question, where would this team have been without this individual?
Player this year has had a dedication to improving her personal playing. She's always been attentive, She's always put tennis first during her season. She's concentrating in practice and focusing during the matches. She plays throughout the summer and plays a match through to the last point, even if it's a nail biter in the third set and we're depending on that to win. She's also got a dedication to the team because she's watching, she's cheering, she's encouraging, and she's making sure that all of her teammates are winning also. She's had a winning season this past season of 12-4. She's also included as part of the number two doubles champs at the Knox Invitational, so we could always count on Miss Aubrey Franklin.
Helped us to a second place finish, Travis Smith.
We have four most valuable athletes in track, male and female most valuable field events, and a male and female most valuable runner. So you have to bear with me for a moment. Track is an individual sport, but it's also a team sport. And for all four of these people, I can tell you that they are really excellent exemplars of team players. They're the hardest working kids on the team. They work at it in the off season. They work multiple sports, but they also have the most impressive individual accomplishments. Our first young lady is our most valuable field events winner. She won long jump at 8 meets this year, placed first or second in every meet through sectional. She was the sectional champ in long jump and conference runner-up. She jumped 16 feet, 10 and 3/4 inches, which for those of you who aren't in track is a very long way. It's within an inch and a half of our school record. She broke the school record in the 1600 meter relay and ran the fastest split on the team. She's a school record holder in the 4x100 relay. She ran the team's fastest 100 and 200 times, and she placed in every event she competed in sectional and conference. Caitlin Sawyer is our most valuable junior. Our most valuable runner was a pretty easy selection. Team voted for 97% of the ballot. I'm not sure what the other 3% were thinking. She ran 11:09 this year, which is 11:09 to 3200, which is 38 seconds better than her own school record. She's the school record holder in the 3200 and the 4x400. She's a TRC champ in the 1600, runner-up in the 800 and 3200, sectional champ in the 3200 and 1600. She won the Hack Wilson Award at Oak Hill Relays this year for most outstanding athlete in the meet, and she's a state qualifier in the 3200 and will be running this Friday at State Anna Meyer. On the guys' side, we have the TRC champion in high jump. He's a runner-up in the 110 hurdles. He's a two-time sectional champ in the high jump and plays fourth at regionals this year. This young individual can jump 6 feet, 7 inches. I'm envious of him. Ramson Bednimrod. Our most valuable runner was in the top three in four different events on the team. He was our team's fastest 3,200 meter runner, our team's fastest miler. He won both the 3,200 and 1,600 of the Oak Hill relays. And over the past, we've had a 3,200 runner who won sectional three times named Seth Murphy. And Alex's time at regional this year was within 2 seconds of his personal best. Alex Goodman is our most valuable runner.
MVP really embodies what Coach Miller said. Where would we be without this young man? And we wouldn't have had near the last few seasons that we had. He's just an extremely hard competitor and very talented also. You just round out all the numbers and it's pretty easy to give. The big award goes to the smallest guy, Aaron Stewart.
Who will provide the leadership and exhibit outstanding skill in the sport? With that question answered, I believe we can look to the leadership that started before our first practice and continues to lead us to semi-state. Lainey Smith, Eleni Schroff, and Abby Malko.
Congratulations to all the award winners up here. You represent Rochester High School in an outstanding manner. I'm going to make a few closing comments. I'll try to keep those brief. I know some of you are ready to move into the next portion. I was just doing some math in my head. This is my 77th Sports Awards program at Rochester High School as the athletic director. I would be my 78th. I missed one a few years back when my dad passed away, but I've been in every one, fall, winter, and spring for the past 26 years. I enjoy seeing young people do outstanding things, and I enjoy recognizing those young people. I do have some closing comments, some thank yous very quickly. First of all, I want to thank the administration at Rochester. We've already talked about Jason, but also Sean Rose and Mr. Ronk over across the way. Christina Hughes is back in the corner. I don't have to say a whole lot about Christina. You guys as parents, you guys as athletes recognize the outstanding job that she does and how much she cares about the athletes and the people at Rochester High School. Please give Christina a big hand. I mentioned our athletic secretary earlier, Sue Cash, and again, thanks for everything that she did, particularly in the time that I was away. I do need to say thank you, and I will tell you just real quickly that after spending 4 weeks in Florida around a football facility, I realized how blessed we were to have people like Greg Bellew and Brian Stockberger and Jim Swank. We take for granted our facilities here at Rochester High School. I will tell you that in the past 4 weeks, our head football coach mowed the practice football field. He mowed the game field. The assistant football coaches lined the game field, including myself. We took out the trash. We cleaned the restrooms because there are no people like Greg Bellew, Brian Stockberger, and Jim Swank to take care of maintenance at facilities in some schools. So we're very, very fortunate. So I know that Brian's here and Jimmy and Greg are not able to be with us, but please give our maintenance people a very round of applause. I want to thank all the coaches. I think until you've done it, and Monty and Lyle are our first year guys this year, you all of a sudden realize that it takes on a whole different life, and it changes your life a great deal when you start coaching and being involved on a regular basis. So I do want to recognize all of our coaches. If you'll just save your applause till the end. First of all, our baseball coaches, our head coach Brian Hooker, his assistants Ryan Wolf and Tony Stasiak. Our golf coaches, Mr. Ronnie Hoffman and Mr. Lyle Lingenfelder. Our girls tennis coach, Ms. Tammy Hooker. Our softball coaches, Carl Holland, Dave Value, Andy Holland, Tom Smith, and Brad Good. Did I miss any? I have a hard time keeping track of all those guys, yeah. I didn't know which one the umpire was yelling at last night. Our track coaches, Ryan Helt, the amazing Ms. Karen Reeves, Ben Brubaker, and Scott Stahlbaum has done a remarkable job at not only our track, but also our cross-country program. Please give all of the coaches a round of applause. Parents, I want to thank you for your support, your encouragement, and your sportsmanship and loyalty to Rochester High School. I need to say a quick thank you to the Rochester Sentinel, to WROI, to Channel 4, and the Rochester Telephone Company for all they do for Rochester Athletics and promoting our programs in the community of Rochester. Last but not least, athletes, and for some of you guys, you're still working on those goals, and you know who you are. But if you did not reach your goals, there are always new goals to be set and met. Set your goals high, be willing to work hard to achieve those goals. Seniors, I'll miss you greatly. It's a great class, and I had a great time with a lot of you guys over the last 4 years. If there are any mistakes with awards, Mrs. Cash and I will be there tomorrow. Please see us in the athletic office. I would say that coaches, as your groups get out, if you will, there will be a Sentinel photographer. It's not Mike Kinney. They're sending an intern. So coaches, if you can kind of help make sure your trophy winners and award winners get to Zebby outside the cafeteria and get them lined up for pictures, that would be greatly appreciated. So at this time, we're going to ask the track team members and their parents remain in the auditorium. Softball team and parents move across the hall to the cafeteria. Golf team and parents move to the library. Tennis team and parents to the main gym. Baseball team and parents to the auxiliary gym. Thank you very, very much for your attendance.